This is the engine compartment. It's a nice compact three-cylinder 988cc power plant. It's a nice little machine. And that's the front view of the car. Go around the side. It's a nice compact little car. I go around the back. You can see it's a four-door hatchback. And it's a Yaris T2. I'll show you the dashboard layout on my new second-hand 8-year-old 2009 Toyota Yaris with a 988cc power plant. I'll switch the ignition on now and you'll see the dashboard light up. This has an onboard computer with a multi-function dashboard. There's a right-hand switch here, which will either give you a readout of your odometer, which is at 29,677 miles, which is a very low mileage for this age of a car. If you press that right-hand switch once, it'll give you your trip since you last set your trip, which I set when I filled the fuel tank when I got the car. I've done 123.3 miles. I'll switch it again and it'll go back to the odometer. If I switch and hold this at this position, the readout for your miles per hour, which you can see is not a clock face speedometer, but it reads out a numerical speed. But if I push it again and hold it there, I can switch between miles per hour and kilometers per hour on this readout. When I first bought the car, it was set in kilometers per hour, and it took some head scratching to figure out how to get into miles per hour. I do that by pressing and holding on your trip mileage, and it'll flash back and forth between miles and kilometers, so you can set that. I'll push again, and I'll leave it on my trip mileage now, which is 123.3, and that's all the right hand switch does. The left hand switch is a 5 position switch. See, now I'm on 9 degrees centigrade, which is the outside temperature. The clock above is sitting at 1:19 in the afternoon. If I push and hold it on the 9 degrees centigrade, the clock will flash on the hours, which you can reset. And once it's flashed the hours, it'll start flashing the minutes, which you can set. And then it'll go back to your outside temperature reading. If you push it again, it'll give you your miles per gallon as you're driving. Now, I'll start driving in a little while. You'll see how this operates. Right now, there's no reading because I'm not driving. Okay, I'll switch it again. And it gives me my average miles per gallon since I last filled the fuel tank, which is 52 miles per gallon, which is a fantastic fuel economy. I press it again, and it tells me how many miles I got left to drive before I have to refill the fuel tank. So I got another 274 miles before I have to stop for gas. I push it again, and it gives me the average miles per hour I've done since I filled the tank. You can see my average miles per hour is 15. That's because all my driving is done in congested traffic. All the speed limits around where I live are 20 miles per hour. The main roads are 30 miles per hour. But you spend more time sitting in traffic than you do driving. So my average speed for the last 23.3 miles is 15 miles an hour. I push it again and it goes back to 9 degrees centigrade. So that's how the Deitch works. I'm going to start up now and drive off. Notice the red light, the flashing is because I don't have my seatbelt on. I put my seatbelt on. There we go. Stop that light flashing. I'm going to start the engine now. There we go. The tachometer starts reading. You can see the tachometer is running at just under 1,000 RPM at idle. Now I'm going to start off now, go into first gear. Oh. Oh, there we go. Break off. First gear. And pull away. Pull away into my congested traffic here. Oh, just a minute. I'm going to go on miles per gallon here. So it's temperature. There we go. Okay, there we go. Go left around the corner. In the second gear, just along the road here. Okay, coming up to my driveway. Going to swing around and back in my driveway. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, in the first gear, swing around. In the reverse, going to back into my driveway now. Switch off now and say goodbye. Home sweet home.